Your trailer. Remember, we are focusing first where we left off from the last video, and that was the three-act structure here, where it was getting your main characters, your setting, and your film premise. So in Adobe Premiere, what did I do? I double-clicked here in my project panel. My film came up. I started exploring, right, by moving the little playhead back and forth. I've already watched the movie once, so I kind of know where things are a little bit, and I had to find those things to show the characters, tell the premise of the movie a little bit, remember, and the setting. So what did I grab? Let's take a look. I first did the in and out points here, right, in the source, grabbed them and dragged them in along with the audio that came with them. So you can see here, I grabbed all of these different clips. After I brought them in here, I selected them, right-clicked on them, and I gave them a label, and I labeled them with a color. This way I know for that part one, for that first thing I'm doing, that three-act structure that's based on this sheet that you have for part one here, I'm labeling all of this stuff that I do now in Premiere as one color, and then I'll do all of this as a second color, third color, and so on, just to stay organized, right? So all these green clips that you see here that I pulled in, these are different pieces. So what did I grab? Okay, I got the beginning where he's walking with his daughter, with his sister, I'm sorry. Then here, he's playing a little basketball and he's in the locker room. And a couple other little pieces here, a couple other pieces for setting. Okay, and with his son, and then something else. Okay, I grabbed all those pieces. Now, I grabbed more than I had to grab. So get more than you have. The in and out points, they can be before and after. You can always cut them down when you get into here in the timeline. And also bring in the audio, because you might be able to use the audio even if you don't see the image. So the audio from it is a good thing to have. The next bracket of stuff that I have here in purple, what that's from, is that it's from number two here. Show the most unforgettable scenes. So I went back in and I picked out parts of my favorite scenes and I stacked them up here right next to each other in the timeline. So that's these pieces. Okay, all those pieces. Now again, I got more than I needed to. And now I'm going to start to kind of cut away at those, break them down a little bit, and see what I can use and what I don't have to use, that kind of thing. So I'm going to bring the playhead to the beginning. I'm going to hit play. The situation is void of any kind of leadership other than his own. So I'm not sure if I'm going to use the audio in some of these pieces, right? Maybe I will. Maybe I won't. I don't know. So I'm going to click the clips one at a time. I'm going to zoom in so you can see a little better here. And what I'm going to do as I'm on this clip and I click the clip to select it is I'm going to go right over to this button here, which allows me to separate the link between the audio and the video for each of the clips that I pulled in. So if I click on it, it now separates. What does that mean? That means that over here, if I click away from it for a moment and I click back on it, it lets me grab just one or just the other. So if I feel like I don't think I need this, I can hit delete and it's gone, right? I still have the clip. The video of the clip is still there, just the audio is gone. So if I played it back, it would look like this. Okay, beautiful. Now, I'm going to skip ahead for 1 second back to this page, and I'm going to go to number four for a moment, because this is something that becomes important throughout the entire thing, and that is choosing music that sets the tone, right? For example, you might choose suspenseful music if it's a thriller, or a lighthearted pop song if it's a comedy, and so on and so on. Now, I already went in and I downloaded a song from this movie, so I'm going to go back into here, and here is the song. Let's see. Okay, great. So I'm going to take just the audio from this song and drag it and put it at the bottom of my trailer. Like that. So it's underneath all the other layers. So now when I play it back from the beginning so far, what do I have? If man is the father, the son is... Okay. So I already like the way it's playing out, and I have very little showing so far. We could always dip the audio later if we want to be able to hear dialogue of what people are actually saying in parts of the movie. So the next step of what I'm going to do here, now that I have those clips lined up, is I'm just going to go through the pieces and I'm going to cut them down and only grab what I need. If I don't feel I need the audio from them, I'm going to get rid of the audio. If I feel like I need to keep the audio, I'm going to leave it there. And then we're going to see how we can blend it all together. But remember, shorten your clips. Right now, I have in total on this part so far, I have over 4 minutes. I don't care if you get to 5, 6 minutes. It doesn't matter. You're going to be cutting it down. We're going to cut this down to, we're going to try to get it down to 1:30, 2 minutes, or something like that. So this is part two. There'll be a third part, which will show you how to do the last few bits on how to kind of put this together after you've edited the main base of what you have.